Welcome to a lesson on solutions to differential equations. In this video, we'll confirm a given function is a solution to a differential equation and determine if a function is a solution to a differential equation. A solution to a differential equation is any function that satisfies the differential equation on the given interval. For our first example, we want to verify that y equals 116 x to the fourth is a solution to the differential equation dy dx equals x times y to the 1/2 on the interval from negative infinity to positive infinity. So again, we want to verify that this function satisfies this differential equation. So we need to first find the derivative of y with respect to x, and then perform substitution into this equation. So if y is equal to 1/16 x to the fourth, we apply the power rule here to find dy dx. So dy dx is going to be equal to 1/16 times the derivative of x to the fourth, which would be 4x to the third. So the same as 4 over 1, so this here is going to simplify. There's one factor of 4 and 4, and 4 factors of 4 and 16. So dy dx is equal to 1/4 x to the third. So now we have enough information to verify that this function is a solution to this differential equation. To verify that dy dx equals x times y to the 1/2, which I'm going to write as the square root of y. Now we'll perform substitution here for dy dx and perform substitution here for y. So we're going to have 1/4 x to the third equals x times the square root of 1/16 x to the fourth. 1/16 x to the fourth is a perfect square, so we have 1/4 x to the third equals x times the square root of 1/16 is 1/4. The square root of x to the fourth is x to the second. It looks like we have it. 1/4 x to the third is equal to, this would be 1/4 x to the third. Therefore, this verifies the given function is a solution to this differential equation. Now we want to verify that y equals 4 cosine 2x plus 6 sine 2x is a solution to y double prime plus 4y equals 0. Notice to verify this, we'll have to find y double prime. But to find y double prime, we'll first have to find y prime. So given y, let's find y prime. Y prime is going to be equal to 4 times the derivative of cosine 2x, which will require the chain rule, because we have a composite function here where the inner function is 2x. So the derivative of cosine 2x is going to be negative sine 2x times 2. Let's put the times 2 here, the negative here, and the sine 2x here. Plus 6 times the derivative of sine 2x. Again, applying the chain rule, this is going to be cosine 2x times 2. Put the times 2 here, and then cosine 2x. So y prime is equal to negative 8 sine 2x plus 12 cosine 2x. And now we need to find y double prime. So y double prime is going to be equal to the derivative of negative 8 sine 2x. So we're going to have negative 8 times the derivative of sine 2x, which is going to be cosine 2x times 2 because of the chain rule. So we have times 2 cosine 2x plus 12 times the derivative of cosine 2x. So again, applying the chain rule, the derivative is going to be negative sine 2x times 2. So there's the negative, there's the 2, and sine 2x. Let's clean this up. We have y double prime equals negative 16 cosine 2x. This will be minus 24 sine 2x. Now we have the information we need to verify the solution. We're trying to verify that y double prime plus 4y equals 0. So we'll substitute all of this for y double prime, and we'll substitute the original function for y. So we'll have negative 16 cosine 2x minus 24 sine 2x. All this is y double prime plus 4 times y equals 0, where y is 4 cosine 2x plus 6 sine 2x. So now we'll distribute and see if it's equal to 0. So we'll distribute the 4 here and here, and things are looking good. This first part stays the same. So we'll have plus 16 cosine 2x and plus 24 sine 2x. Again, this is good news because notice how this term and this term are opposites, and so are these two. Therefore, we have 0 equals 0, verifying the given function is a solution to the differential equation. Okay, I think we have time for one more. Is y equals e to the negative x plus 2x e to the negative x a solution to this given differential equation? Notice how we'll have to find the first derivative here and the second derivative here. So we'll first find dy dx. The derivative of e to the negative x will require the chain rule. This is going to be e to the negative x times the derivative of negative x. So this is going to be negative e to the negative x plus, to find the derivative of this term here, we'll have to apply the product rule and the chain rule. So we'll have the first function, 2x, times the derivative of the second, which again is going to be e to the negative x times the derivative of negative x. This will be negative e to the negative x plus the second function, e to the negative x, times the derivative of the first function, which is 2x, so that'll be times 2. Let's go ahead and clean this up. So we have dy dx equals, this is negative e to the negative x, and this is plus 2 e to the negative x. So we'll have a positive 1 e to the negative x. This will be minus 2x e to the negative x. And now to find the second derivative, we'll find the derivative of this. So second derivative of y with respect to x will equal the derivative of e to the negative x, which we saw above is e to the negative x times negative 1, or just negative e to the negative x, minus, and then we'll have to apply the product rule with the chain rule to find the derivative of this term here. So we'll have the first function, 2x, times the derivative of the second function. The derivative of e to the negative x is negative e to the negative x, plus the second function, e to the negative x, times the derivative of the first, which would be 2. Now it is important that we have this in parentheses, so we're subtracting this entire quantity. Let's go ahead and clean this up. Notice here if we distributed negative 1 here, we're going to have negative 2 e to the negative x. Here's a negative 1 e to the negative x. So we have negative 3 e to the negative x. And then this product here is going to be a positive, so plus 2x e to the negative x. So now using the first derivative here, we'll perform substitution into our equation. And then we'll use our second derivative here, perform substitution here. So we're going to have negative 3 e to the negative x plus 2x e to the negative x plus 2 times dy dx, so that's e to the negative x minus 2x e to the negative x plus y, where y is the original function, so we have e to the negative x plus 2x e to the negative x equals 0. If this is true, then our function is a solution. If it's not true, then it's not. Let's go ahead and clear our parentheses and see if this is equal to 0. So we have plus 2 e to the negative x minus 4x e to the negative x . Now let's identify the like terms. Here's an e to the negative x, as well as here and here. Looking at the coefficients, we have negative 3 plus 2 and then plus 1. Therefore, these terms sum to 0. Notice the three remaining terms are also like terms. They each contain a factor of x e to the negative x here, here, and here. Notice if we add this first term with this third term here, we're going to have 4x e to the x minus 4x e to the x, again, would be 0. Which verifies that the given function is a solution, since we've just verified that 0 equals 0, which is what it takes to show the given function is a solution to the differential equation. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.